Okay, so last class we were discussing with respect to this nested mapping concept. So in this nested mapping, we were just checking, we have to have the number of a set of values to be generated till n values with respect to ith variable as well as the jth variable. So we just discussed how it works. So keeping this concept, we just generated the enumerate interval concept with 1 to n and enumerate interval with respect to, that is, we have to have the combination made, that is with each ith value, all combination with respect to jth value. Similarly, the all type of combinations we have to make it. So for making that, we make use of two loops. So in C program, when we say it is two loops, in Lisp, how do we generate two loops? Is nothing but with the help of map procedure, we can make use of generating the two loops concept, bringing the two loops concept. So how do we write this map within bracket? As the procedure, we will be passing the lambda procedure, and as the body of that lambda procedure, once again we will be calling another map procedure, where we will be having the procedure defined with respect to jth lambda, lambda of j. And as the body of this lambda, what is our expectation? We just have to have the combination made of I and j values. So how do we make it? List of ij. And with respect to how many values we wanted, this is inner map is for generating with respect to the jth loop. So how many j values we can generate? The j values which we can have will be from 1 to I minus 1. So for that sake, what we have done is inner loop will be having, inner interval will be having 1 to I minus 1. Closed all the brackets till the lambda 1 over here. Lambda of I. Till here, lambda of I is closed. After this, as the map procedures, the next argument, we will be having enumerate interval for ith loop. How many values we can have? We can generate 1 to n values. 1 to n values could be generated by using enumerate interval concept for variable I. So that from this particular list, we can pick each value. For this each value, we can make the combination with respect to j. So like this, we can make the combinations. So in last class, I have shown you, if your n value is 4, how the output would be represented with respect to this two map concepts. And to make it to be as, since the output will be in the form of list of list, but we wanted it to be in the a single list concept. So how do we make this? We have to make it to be, we can make use of the accumulate procedure. To this accumulate procedure, what is the argument which we have to pass? We have to combine two lists together. Two lists of list contents should be combined together so that it becomes like a single list. So we make use of the append procedure. Since we are passing append procedure, what should be the last content when we encounter nil? It should be the same empty list itself. So nil. So this accumulate, this is just a partial code of how it works. That is the main concept of generating the loop inside the loop part. Okay, and making it to be as a single list. So as the continuation, what we could do is, we have defined this entire thing, this entire portion, whatever we have right now defined, that I could have given it with respect to a single name called flat map procedure, where I am, this is similar to the map procedure, but this is explicitly for two loops concept. Okay, here we are expecting two loop concept. Before the map, the single map procedure, how it works, it was like a single loop it will be working with respect to all values of your list. So flat map procedure, where we are expecting the procedure, where we are passing the procedure and the sequence. Here what we have, we are calling the same, this body part, we are writing it over here. Accumulate, append, nil, and the map we are calling this portion, that is this portion. From here to here, this entire portion, we are passing it as the procedure here. This will be passed as the procedure here. Okay. And the sequence will be nothing but, sorry. One second. So from here to here, it will be passed. So the sequence will be nothing but enumerate interval till n. So this will be the content which we will be passing as the procedure, the lambda procedure. And the sequence will be nothing but it will be this enumerate interval will be the sequence till n. Okay. So now what we have done, if you remember the structure from this, if you remember in this format, what we have generated till now, we have made it to be as the combinations. Each combination we have built. Here, whatever I have listed, it is only the with respect to the prime number combination I have made. But similar to this, we will be having all combinations generated. So 2, 1, next, if you pick with respect to 3, 1, 3, 2. Then comes 4, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4. Next comes 6, 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5. So all combinations would be generated. So that is what is the flat map procedure doing it. Okay. And how the contents would be? The contents would be listed since we have used accumulate procedure with respect to append. So it will be something like list of. So each combination would be taken. 2, 1, then comes 3, 1, then comes 3, 2. So like that it goes on. So this is how, if your n is 3, this is how your output would be. Okay. This is what you will be getting once you complete with your flat map procedure. Now, is it sufficient? No. What we are supposed to do? We are supposed to pick each content. That is, once you have finished generating this, we have to pick each value of this. 2 has to be picked, 1 has to be picked, and add it up and see whether it is prime or not. So for checking whether it is prime or not, we could make use of the filter procedure, right? But we have to write a procedure for picking the contents 2 and 1 and adding it. That result should be appended to be as a third argument. That is, we have to append this value 3 as the third argument. This is how your result. Complete this 2, 1 with the value result to be as 3. This complete this 1 should become like your 1 content. That is first two values and the third one will be your result. And that too it is, it's a prime number. So this is how you have to form the output also. So how do we write now? So our next task is to check whether it is prime number or not. So since the output is in this format, if you are using this map procedure, we can pick each element. So when you are saying for this, if you are saying car of this particular list, what will happen? You will be getting the output to be as 2, 1. This will become your car of your the element which you are going to pick up, right? So once you get this content, we can now pick up easily the remaining things. 2 and 1, you can split it up. So keeping that in mind, we are writing this prime sum procedure. Just to check, we have already defined the prime procedure. Remember when we were discussing this order of growth concept, at that time we have defined this prime procedure. So making use of that prime procedure, what value we are passing is, we are passing the each content we are extracting and we are passing it to be as the pair here. And it is taking the first car of this pair and the next element has to be picked. So when you are saying next element has to be picked, we will be using the selected to be as car of CDR of pair. So in short, we can write it to be as CADR. So these two contents should be added. So we have made use of the plus operator. That result, we want to check whether it is prime number or not. So we are calling this procedure prime, which we have long back defined it. And it is since this prime procedure, it returns true or false. Okay. So as the output of your prime sum procedure, which is nothing but it is going to return whether it is true or false. Okay. After this, now we have the other module which we have to think about is if it is a prime number, what we have to have? We have to reconstruct the pair to be as, which should comprise of car of your element, then the second element, which is CADR of your pair. Along with this, the result also should be added. So we should have the result as the third argument. That is the third content of your list. So we are making, we have defined a make pair sum procedure where you are accepting a single argument, which is the pair of your content, each pair you are extracting and reconstructing it to be as a list. So we are directly using the list. The first value will be nothing but car of that pair. The second value will be nothing but CADR of that pair, the second argument, second value. As the third argument or the third value, which will be nothing but plus operator onto adding these two values together. And that result will be like your third argument, third value of this list. So this make pair sum procedure is going to return a list with the combination of, that means with the, which will have the contents of first element, second element, and summation of these two contents. Okay. As a whole, if you see, so right now we have a split and we have defined the procedures like this. First, we have generated the values. Then we have, when we were generating the values, we had list contents. By using this accumulate with the append procedure, we have made it to be as a single list. That is list of list contents we have made so that each pair you can extract it. Okay. So for that, we have made use of this flat map procedure, which will help us return a list of pair of contents. And we have defined another module to check whether it is a prime number and named it to be as prime sum procedure, where you will pick each content. Each by using the selector, we will be selecting each content and we will add it and check whether it is prime or not. And after that, if it is a prime number, then we have to reconstruct it back. If it is not a prime number, then we can ignore it. If it is a prime number, then we have to reconstruct it back. So for reconstructing it back, how do we reconstruct it? For that, we have made use of the list itself. Here we are not calling it again and again. So what we have done is we have directly used list. The first value is car of it. Second value is CADR of the pair. Third value is nothing but adding those two contents together. So now putting everything together. So we have defined the defining this prime sum pair. We are taking the argument n. Okay. N is nothing but what is our maximum value. So then we are first making use of this map procedure and passing make pair sum procedure as the argument. Okay. For this, what should be the content? The list which we have to have. For this, whatever content which we have to filter first, right? So we are applying the filter procedure. The name of the argument what we are passing as the procedure, which is nothing but prime sum procedure, we are passing it. For this filter procedure, what will be the list what we are going to get? It will be nothing but whatever we get from our flat map procedure. So flat map procedure, and what we have to pass as the procedure? We have to pass the lambda of I, the two loops we have to pass. So we have written it lambda of I and then the map procedure lambda of j, which will help us generate the list contents. So till here, which will help us generate this two loops to map inside a map, which is nothing but ith loop as well as the jth loop. In that way, it will be working. For this flat map procedure, yeah, so we have closed with the lambda procedure till here. And as the argument for this flat map procedure, what will be the list which we are going to generate? It will be with the help of enumerate interval with respect to 1 to n value. Map procedure had two arguments. One was procedure. So that will be replaced with this content. So PROC, which we had, will be replaced with this content. And this was the list which we had, the sequence. This will be our sequence with respect to the flat map procedure. So from this, as the output, you would be getting the content to be as list of, if your n is 3, if suppose if your n is 3, it will generate all possible combinations. Remember that it should be 1 less than or equal to j less than n, sorry, j less than I less than or equal to n. So 1 and 1, it's not possible. 2, 1 is possible. If it is 3, if your I becomes 3, 3, 1 is possible. Then comes 3, 2. 3, 3 will not be generated because the loop goes till, enumerate interval goes till I minus 1. So only till 2 it will generate. So this will be the output from the flat map procedure. So this list will be the content which you will be passing it to the filter procedure. For the filter procedure, the procedure as what is the predicate which we are going to apply is prime sum procedure. So now what it does, it will pick each content. When you apply car of it, you will be getting list of 2, 1. So it will just take, pick 2 and then it will pick 1. So 2 plus 1, 3. So is it a prime number? Yes, it will return it to be as true. So once it is true, what it does, you are making it to be as the flat map. So it will, from this filter procedure, what you will have, it will just return those contents which are only prime. So it will be 2, 1. Next, 3 plus 1 will be taken. So 3 plus 1, 4, no. 3 plus 2, which is 5. So that will be taken. So 3, 2. So as the output for this filter procedure, you will be having this as the output. And this will be passed as the list for your map procedure. In the map procedure, what is the argument which you are make? What is the procedure which we are passing? It is make pair sum. In this make pair sum, what we have used, we just have used list of car of, by using this map procedure, what will happen? You will be having this make pair sum procedure getting called with car of this particular list. When you apply car of this particular list, it will be nothing but list of 2, 1. So when list of 2, 1 is passed, it will just return back a list stating that it is 2, 1, 2 plus 1, 3. So this will be returned. So since it is a map, it will be another list. Next, it will be picking the next content. So 3, 2, and 5 will be returned. 5 will be attached along with this list. This is done. So as the final output, you will be getting this as your final result. So here, what is your learning point here is, takeaway is, sir, how do we have, how do we generate two loop concept? That is, more than one loop if you have to have, how do we generate it? And if you have to apply, or if you have to, when you are making use of this flat map procedure, how your output will be. And if you have to convert, that is, if you have to append, make it to be as a single list, how, by using this append, how when you use it, how the output would look like. After that, when you are applying the filter procedure, how the output will look like. And the last step, how do you want the final output? We want the final output along with the contents. So how do we add the result to our existing list? So how do we pick each content and how do we add the contents to it? So these are the things which you are expected to understand from here. So that's all about sequence of procedures. So here also, we have kept on calling the procedures one after the other based on the requirement. So how do we apply this sequence of procedures? And how the output will be passed on. Any queries? This will be more clear if you try to do it with respect to by using pen and paper. If you put it in your paper pen by seeing the definition, by applying the substitution model, it will be more clear. Oh, any queries? So the next topic is symbolic data. So before going for symbolic data, we can do some programs. Share today's lab programs so you can switch on your machine. Is the question visible? Hope all of you have finished with the last lab programs.
Not completely, ma'am. We'll definitely. Today is a lab, ma'am.
Today is a lab. Both, only two slides were pending, that and this one.
Okay. I thought I will finish by next lab and last.
And I hope all of you have seen your calendar. 9th is working day. 9th, that is second Saturday, it's a working day.
Okay.
If I'm not wrong, it's working day with respect to Tuesday's timetable. Yeah, it's Tuesday's timetable, October 9th. It's the second Saturday. So any doubts regarding last lab?
Actually, I haven't completed, ma'am. Can I do that and come back to this?
Yeah, you finish the previous one and then do this lab.
Okay.
Anyways, I'm uploading the slides for lab. In class material, I have uploaded today's lab programs also. It's a PPT, so I'm updating the same file again and again. What is your status? are you doing?